Well, I can't tell you how excited I am because today I get to go back to camp. I'm out here at Trevecca University in the summer for farm camp, where a variety of ages from fifth grade and up get to learn a whole host of techniques from permaculture to beekeeping. And I'm along for the ride, and we're gonna see how much fun we can get into today. Well, Jason, what are we learning here today?
Each day they learn how to take care of one particular animal or livestock that we have. So today we're doing bees.
Oh, great.
Getting to the beehives, we get suited up, and yesterday afternoon, each afternoon we watch a film about a certain either food policy or nutrition, or yesterday we watched a film about bees. And so today we're gonna get into the hive and actually see it with our eyes.
Fantastic.
We have a full day camp. It's 7:30 to 3:30. They learn a new skill every day, how to build a garden, how to plant a tree, how to build a compost pile. Today, they're doing morning chores. We come out here every morning and take care of the greenhouse. Uh-huh. We feed the fish in our aquaponics system.
Inside
the greenhouse, we have three aquaponics tanks. And so they feed the fish and make sure the water levels are good. They water the plants. And now they're doing a little bit of weeding out here in the gardens.
Tell me a little bit about the beginnings of farm camp and kind of how it operates.
Yeah, well, we started the farm camp because the farm was really started to help the community learn how to grow good food. And so we wanted to reach out to our neighborhood and the local schools and invite children, youth in during their summer times to learn how to do everything that we do here, which is everything from taking care of animals like pigs, chickens. We have livestock guardian dogs and goats. Our fish, our worms, our bees, and then the permaculture gardens we have, the orchard, and the vegetable garden. So we, in a week, we try to teach them as much of all of those techniques as we can.
I'll wear this. Let's do it.
I cannot see anything up here, so I feel like the monster under the bed.
Boys, come with me. Okay, guys, if you'll look over here, I'm going to start the smoker.
Start the smoker!
Now, we're not going to be in there long, so we're just going to put some pine needles and wood chips, and then we close it up. And then smoke comes out of here. Another reason that this works is bees communicate. How do they communicate?
Well, there's one reason to make them calm sometimes.
Makes them calm. One reason is they spread alarm bells by smell, not sound. So if they can't smell, if we're blocking their radar with the smoke, then they can't communicate alarm. They can't communicate distress. And so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna open up the bottom of the, or the top of the hive. We're gonna drop a little smoke in there and let them think about it. And they're gonna spread the word around, hey, there's something going on. Bees build off of this pattern and make little pots to put their honey in. Then they cap them off, and that's called capped honey.
I think this is worth the sweat.
I know, this is really cool.
What are we doing here today?
Well, right now we are doing what we call sifting. And what we're doing is we're taking this fantastic dirt down here that's just covered in mulch and it's all clumped up. And it's essentially chicken manure,
right?
Because this is where our chickens usually do their business. It's where they are most of the time.
Right.
And so we're shoveling it up. And what it does, it goes through this, and while it's spinning, it breaks it down. And we have buckets and a wheelbarrow down here to collect it. And what we're going to do with that is take it up and use it to make garden beds out of.
You get to do a little housekeeping as well as production of some good old-fashioned hen manure compost.
Yes. Last year I did farm camp, and this is my second year interning. And really, Jason does most of the teaching, but I help like reinforce things. I help set things up. I help the kids. I teach them some things that I can.
So we're learning so many good methodologies here at farm camp. How are you incorporating them in your own home or lifestyle?
I think one of the things that we teach them the most is how to maintain like garden beds and just like things in general. One of the things I've learned how to do is take care of chickens. So after last year, I have four chickens at my house now, and I also have a humongous garden. And so one of my hopes is that these kids will go home and be like, hey, I can grow food by myself, and I can maybe take care of a chicken if my mom will let me. And that's a really important aspect in life, to learn how to do those things, because if you like drive down Nolensville Road, the only thing you see is fast food and gas stations. Like, how many farmers markets do you see? So by teaching them how to build and maintain a garden, they can go home and get fresh food. And fresh food is fantastic. It's like my favorite thing to eat, honestly. I could live off of fruits and vegetables. And so a lot of what we teach them is how to do that and how to like maintain a healthy diet and like what they need and not to be eating.
Fantastic. Well, I can't tell you how excited I am seeing you work around children and someone like yourself with so much knowledge and so much personal experience from your home, and getting to bring that over here and work with the kids like that. It's just a great inspiration to me. So thank you for your work.
Yeah, thank you.
Awesome. So we're standing in front of a beautiful bin of soil and worms. Can you tell me a little bit more about what's going on here?
This is our vermicompost bin. It's basically, we just throw all our scraps in here, and we've got worms in here. Worms love coffee grounds. And when it's done, they just break it down, uh-huh, and they turn it into beautiful, rich soil. Oh, there's a worm.
This is gorgeous.
Yeah.
If anybody wants a little bit of water on them to cool them down. Just a little. Okay, just a little. Not soaked. Just a spritz. Would you mind going around and getting us a lot of coffee grounds? It's fine to get worms in there too. We're gonna actually come out here and build a lasagna bed, which we actually start just with the grass. We put down a layer of cardboard, and then we begin adding lasagna layers, just like you'd add cheese, noodles, sauce, on up. We add straw, barn bedding, coffee grounds, leaves, and we're watering it the whole time until we frost it. The top layer of cheese is, for us, enough compost to start a garden. So we plant it right there, and we're basically building a garden on top of a compost pile.
Right.
We throw worms in there, and it's fertile for 5 to 7 years. We don't have to do anything to it. It just keeps going. And it tends to have very few weeds because we've started with a clean plate, with sheet mulching.
Right there. Where it's kind of really damp, where it looks damp and wet.
Well, I can't tell you how much fun I've had spending my day out here at farm camp here in Trevecca University this summer. Learned so much from different farm stations, working with bees, sifting hen manure, working with this lasagna gardening project here. So that's all great, fascinating things to learn. Another thing I had heard from Jason is that they have an environmental justice program here, and it's just really rewarding to see these interns and the students working with this program doing a community outreach and really just working hands-on with these children here.
Hey guys, we're doing great.
Great job.
For inspiring garden tours, growing tips, and garden projects, visit our website at volunteergardener.org or on YouTube at the Volunteer Gardener channel, and like us on Facebook.